Good morning, Tacoma New Life Church. Today is Tuesday, November 17th, and we are on day two of the Bible reading plan, Gaining Godly Wisdom. And I think today is the start of our four-week lockdown, and that's not really going to affect us at church. We're still able to operate in our normal capacity that we've been doing so for the past, 5-6 months. I think the only thing that will change is how we do praise, but we still got to figure that out, right? But so let us keep moving forward and just continue to be faithful in the ways that we've been following Jesus and serving the Lord. With that said, this new Bible reading plan that we are doing is a short one. It's a short but sweet one, but at the same time, I do believe that there is a lot that God wants us to faithfully consider. You know, if you could ask God for anything, what would you ask for? If God were to say to you, "My child, what do you want? Ask and it will be yours." What would you ask for? Why? You know, I think for a lot of us, our instant answer without putting much thought into it is we would probably ask for money. Maybe you'd ask for riches. Maybe you'd ask to be rich, like filthy rich. Or maybe you just ask for just have more money. Right? Or maybe you'll ask for just enough money so you'll never have to worry about finances ever again, right? Because you could have asked for all the riches in the world, but you want to sound a little humble, right? I would imagine that someone out there would want great health, better health, right? With no sickness, no disease, no cancer, no high blood pressure or high cholesterol, you know, no diabetes or whatever, right? Just better health. Or maybe you want your old body back. I have no idea. And maybe there'd be some of us who would want to go back into time and do things differently, right? Knowing what we now know, going back into time and doing things just a little bit differently. There are so many possibilities when we ask ourselves this question, right? We can be silly. We can allow our minds to wander. Ultimately, we would have to ask, like, okay, God, like, what are you up to? What are you trying to accomplish in my life? You know, this morning we are in 1 Kings chapter 3, verses 1 to 14. And for the sake of time, like, I don't want to read that for us this morning. So make sure that you go at some point and read that, whether that you want to read that right now, like by pausing this video and coming back and pressing play, or after we're done watching this video, go ahead and spend some time in that scripture. But in 1 Kings chapter 3, verses 1 to 14, right, we have Solomon. And if you don't know who Solomon is King David's son. And at this particular place in scripture, he has a marriage alliance with Pharaoh, right, who is the king of Egypt. And scripture tells us that Solomon loved the Lord, right, that he was following in the footsteps of his father David, right? Like he was following his statues. I believe that's the exact phrasing they use. And at this time, Solomon is a newly appointed king, right? He's king, but he's pretty young. And it's in our scripture that at this time that Solomon is at Gibeon offering sacrifices to the Lord, and God actually appears to him in a dream and asks Solomon, "Ask what I shall give you." In other words, tell me what you want me. Tell me what I should give you. And I love how Solomon responds. Right, I'm going to read for you what he says in verses 7 to 9. He says, "And now, O Lord my God, you have made your servant king in place of David my father, although I am but a little child. I do not know how to go out or come in, and your servant is in the midst of your people whom you have chosen, a great people, too many to be numbered or counted for multitude. Give your servant," right, he's referring to himself, "give your servant therefore an understanding mind to govern your people, that I may discern between good and evil, for who is able to govern this your great people?" Right, God asks him for whatever he wants, and his response is so selfless, and it's mature way beyond his age. he says, I am but a little child. He doesn't even view himself as somebody fit to be a king. He's like, I don't even know like how to go out or come in. And yet you have chosen me to lead these great people of yours. And what does he want from God? He wants an understanding mind to govern God's people. Right? He asks for wisdom to be the king that God has appointed him to be. I mean, wow. Right? He could have asked for anything. Anything at all. And he asks for wisdom and understanding. Right? Not to be the smartest person alive, but so that he may serve God and honor him through the responsibility that's been given to him. You know, Solomon would write in the book of Proverbs, for the Lord gives wisdom, from his mouth come knowledge and understanding. Right? He would later say in chapter 4, verse 7, the beginning of wisdom is this. Get wisdom, right? The beginning of wisdom is get wisdom. Though it costs you all you have, get understanding. You know, Solomon was a man who had it all. Right? Scripture tells us that, man, you name it, Solomon had it. Yet, he found godly wisdom to be one of the most valuable things he could ever have. One of the most valuable things that he could ever possess. Right? Solomon saw that wisdom would not only enrich his life, but the lives of the people he was responsible for. Our author for this devotional writes, in a world where good and bad seem to be mixed up, walking in the wisdom of God will help us make decisions that will protect and sustain us. And so for us as a church, how do you go about gaining wisdom? Like, how do you even begin to increase your wisdom? Like, what can we do to walk in the wisdom of God? Like, I don't have all the answers for you this morning, but I know a great place to start, and that's with asking God. If you want more wisdom, ask God. Do you want to have greater wisdom to better serve God's people, to better fulfill his will in your life? Ask God. You see, ask God for more of his wisdom, and from there, would you spend more time with him? Would you spend more time in his word? We can also gain more godly wisdom by picking the brain of people we respect, trust, or even look up to. Right? What better way to get more godly wisdom than to pick the brain of somebody we view as godly people in our lives? I mean, whatever the case, here is a charge to us this morning to seek more of God's wisdom. Right? Not to be smart, not to flaunt our brain power, right? Our biblical knowledge, right? Not to win a Bible quiz or to, you know, whatever, right? We should desire more wisdom, because I believe this, that as we gain more godly wisdom, that we can be better used by him. With more wisdom, you will be better aligned with God's will, with God's purpose. You will be able to see things better from God's perspective. And so I ask you the question this morning, I leave you with this question this morning: how might God increase your wisdom today? I believe that is something for all of us to pray about today. Until then, I pray that the Lord would bless you, that he would keep you, and that he would anoint you with a little bit of his wisdom today. Until then, may you go in peace. Amen and amen.